Hey, I'm RT and welcome back to RT's World. So, today I have a very fancy casino machine for you and it is called the Horse Gambling Game. And yeah, as the name already suggests, it's all about horse racing. But before we start with the exploratory part of this video and I show you the casino behind me, let's thank again Tristan for his great support of the channel. He always writes nice comments, always writes perfect suggestions. And this time he wrote, "Love it. You've got to do a horse race gambling machine, like in casinos." And he also suggests that there are mostly giant builds out there that you don't want to have basically in your multiplayer world because they use much land and also produce a lot of lag. So I tried to make a compact one and I also replied, as you can see here in this comment on your screen, that I will try to do so. And I already made a giant one. You can already check this one out. It's in the info card section on the right corner on your screen. And yeah, let's dive into this video here. So, as you may saw in the preview, we have here three rows of horses. We have the diamond horse, the golden horse, and the iron horse. And yeah, this horse is just for decoration purposes. We have a start line and we have a finish line and we have a total of 8 lamps to cover. So the horse has to race 8 blocks in order to win. Of course, there are also draws. So if, for example, 2 horses win and you bet the right horse, you also would win. So that's completely possible. But if your horse does not win, you lose your bet. And how it works is you choose either diamond, gold or iron, that's mostly obvious, and you insert a diamond block in there. And yeah, here are the prices, that's the diamond blocks you can win. And yeah, if you win, you win 2 diamond blocks, and if you lose, you basically lost 1 diamond block. Let's go with the diamond one this time. So we bet on the diamond horse, the most, the one on the top. We see we locked in our diamond block here. And let's see which one wins. And of course you could always step up the game by using, for example, netherite ingots or netherite blocks even, since it takes a long time to finish this game. So it's really high bets and high rewards, also high risk, high reward, of course. And yeah, as we can see, our horse is doing pretty damn bad. So let's see if it can catch up to the other two horses. And yeah, it takes around 30 seconds for this casino to finish, and yeah, now it finished and it gets reset. This video will be structured into 2 parts, whereas the first part will be I explain everything to you, how it works, and also show you that it's very compact. So I tried to make it really not that big and I made a lot of effort to compact it down. And in the second video we will build it block by block together and you can follow me just in the block by block tutorial. First of all, how do we choose our horses? So we have here 3 different hoppers representing the 3 different colors of the horses: diamond, gold and iron. We have here 3 item filters, each of them filled with 18 slots in the 18 diamond blocks in the first slot or whatever your currency is, and a bunch of other items in the other slots. And yeah, you can see it like that. Our earnings will be in these barrels here down. So if you're the casino owner, that's where your profits will get stored. And here are the prices, that's where the winning dropper is. So next up we have here the 3 item filters, very basic stuff. We have here all the item filters, and after they filtered through we have here a row of repeaters that just transfer the signal. And what they do is they get observed by those observer blocks. They will power the orange circuit here, powering this T flip-flop. And by powering this T flip-flop, we simply close the whole insert bar here with the blocks, so nobody can put in additional diamond blocks. If you are, for example, a very, try to trick the casino and you want to put in 2 diamonds blocks at the same time, you could do that with more players. But if you put in 2 diamond blocks and you lose, you would simply lose 2 diamond blocks. And if you would do that and you would win, you would win nothing, because it's also 2 diamond blocks the price. So yeah, that's basically not in the favor of the customers to put in 2 diamond blocks simultaneously. And also this is completely multiplayer friendly. We have not a lot of hoppers, we have not a lot of clocks, and yeah, if there are clocks, they're not running that long. Next up, we will power these T flip flops here at the bottom, dropper ones. And for the slot we choose, the sword will get transferred into this row here, powering the comparator, powering the depowering the torches and therefore powering these torches on top, and it will indicate which one we locked in. Next up, we will have here the yellow circuit. We combine all those outputs into one single line and then go to this clock here. This clock here is set to 1, 2, 5, 10 ticks. It takes 10 ticks to go one around. And yeah, that's how fast our horses are basically racing. We could increase the speed here, but I would suggest this speed here. Otherwise, you would run into issues with the timing. Then we will go into the green circuit, and the green circuit simply connects everything together. And it doesn't matter if it's green or the lime green. We have three stacks of circuits here, as you can see here from the side, and those all lead up into the red circuits. We have here simple, or not simple, it's just a signal strength adder. So if we have here, for example, just look at the top row here, we power this 50% odds dropper with a non-stackable and a stackable item. It will get transferred into the hopper and give a signal strength of either 1 or 3. If it's 1, so if it's the redstone one, nothing will happen. The horse will stay at its current position. But if it's the stone sword, signal strength 3 is achieved. We power this repeater, send two pulses into this signal strength adder, and we basically power this red line here. And if it gets all the way up to signal strength 8, the horse won. And we have this three times here. And I can show you the mechanism here. I built it over there too. So if we power this two pulse tick, we have signal strength 1. If we do it again, signal strength 2. Do it again, signal strength 3. You get the point. And here's the reset circuit. There we reset everything. So that's our pulse adder. Then we have three of those pulse adders here. They lead into these red circuits. And if we reach signal strength 8, which is this block here, they will power this white circuit here, which is an end gate. And this end gate, combined with the end gate of the selected horse, for example, if we selected a diamond one, this torch will be on too, powering this repeater, depowering this torch. And if for some reason the diamond horse won, this lamp would also power on, this redstone would power on, it would close the end gate. So this one is depowered, this one is depowered, this one will also be depowered, powering this redstone torch here, powering the gray circuit, and firing two times the dropper with the diamonds in there. So that's how we get from the end gate to the prize. If any other torch would lit up, for example, if we would have also chosen the diamond one, so this torch is off, but the golden horse, the middle one, would win, this torch is off, nothing would happen because this torch is still on, this torch is still on, so we wouldn't win nothing. That's the end gate that basically gives us the prize. And simultaneously, we also power the pink circuit. It just combines all the three rows. If one of them is starting to get to the signal strength 8, it will combine everything into the purple circuit. The purple circuit simply resets all those dropper T flip-flops, resets this dropper T flip-flop here, and it also powers this pulse extender, which is then basically depowering our signal strength adder. That's what the lever here was representing. That's basically the pulse extender. It simply extends the signal over there and everything will be reset. So all the signal strength will be deleted out of the memory cells. Yeah, I guess I covered now every single circuit. We have, of course, three horses here, and we have also the music that's going on. It's here. That's our music playing. It's simply a little like final touches that I wanted to add. But yeah, that's basically everything explained. And yeah, that leads us now to the building part of this casino. Welcome to the building part. First of all, we want to start with a 9x17 platform. 9 obviously this direction, 17 the other one. And then we want to go to the corners and place in the two decorative blocks, whichever you want to choose, like this. So leave one room, then this one, diagonally that one. Same goes for the other corner. Then we have here this 14 gap in the middle, and we want to go one quartz block, then one red block, a concrete block, then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, another red block, smooth quartz blocks, and then we have three hoppers. And those three hoppers should all basically face into blocks like this. So make them face into this direction. Do the same for the other row on the bottom, but face them into those blocks here. And then get yourselves some barrels and simply place them like this. Also cover everything with spruce trapdoors like that. So that's where our profits will end up in the end. So next up, we want to do the first row of lamps. So it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Then we have another block of quartz. And here, 2 blocks of quartz. And then we simply repeat it upwards. So it's 1, 2, 1, 2. Red block, 8 lamps in between, 8 lamps in between, red block, quartz block, then we want to have a smooth quartz block stair, like this. And then another row of smooth quartz blocks. We can already skip this block here. And then we have the three indicator lamps, and then we have simply gold, diamond, and iron. And from here on, we can already draw our frame, which will be made out of the spruce blocks, and also the outer one made of this stripped, or what is it called? Yeah, stripped spruce blocks. Like that. So that's our casino from the front, and of course I forgot to fill in the gaps here. Like this. And next up, we want to make sure that we have here item frames, and we place them here, here, oh no, here. And we want to grab ourselves some horse armor. We want the iron one, the gold one, and the diamond one. And we have iron, gold, diamond in this order. And of course, we could also put in, yeah, for example, where is it? Where's my frames? Could put here a display of which blocks we have to put in there. And decorative part will be like your choice. You could put there some signs with start and finish, also some explanatory signs, also some decorational blocks, maybe even a horse. But we won't do it now in the tutorial. We now will grab a dropper, and that's where all our winnings are. And we simply put in one stack of diamond blocks for the sake of this tutorial. So next up, I want to cover myself in redstone blocks like this, and then I want to have some wool, this light blue one. We will start here by simply going out 2 blocks like that, then 1 block like this, and another row like that. Also replace this row here. And we have to put in their repeaters, so make sure you put them in first. And then we have to put in our redstone, our comparators, and here. To make a hole, and 3 redstone torches like this. Nice. So we also can gain access now to our dropper here in the back, in the bottom. And yeah, that's the first piece done. Next up, we want to put in here a diamond block, here a gold block, and here an iron block. So we can also see from the front that everything is nice. So as soon as those blocks are in, we want to open the hoppers, put there some diamond blocks in the first slot. We want to make sure we put a lot of diamond blocks, and it should go down to 18 automatically. It should stop there, then it's right. And I already did it for the other two hoppers. And here in the barrels, there are then your diamond blocks. And then we want to grab ourselves 2 repeaters and put them in like this. Then some light blue wool droppers. Then we want to grab ourselves for the reset circuit some magenta wool, like that, and placing droppers facing in the other way. And then we want to make sure that we put in a stone sword in each of those droppers, like that. The right ones will be empty. Then we have here 3 comparators, here a line of redstone, and then I want to grab myself just very quick some blue wool, and we go 1 row. 2 rows, 3 rows, and a 4th one, like this. And from here on, we simply fill everything out to make this nice platform. So, then it's a little bit tricky. We have to use this kind of crisscross pattern where we want to make sure that none of the lines are interfering and we're also not wasting a ton of repeaters. So we fill in the spaces with some redstone dust. And then we can already place in our orange circuit, which is this one here. And for the orange one, we have to place our sticky pistons. I will remove the gold blocks just for make it easier to place in the sticky pistons, and then I simply move it back in there. Oh no, I messed this one up. Should all face into the blocks. Then we have here 1, 2, 3. 3 pieces of redstone. Another piece there. Then we have here a redstone repeater, a redstone comparator. 2 pieces like this, droppers facing into each other, and in the one which is not connected to comparator, we place in a stone sword. And then we want to place in some observers facing those repeaters. Place some redstone there, keep the redstone from connecting over there. And then, yeah, we simply connect it like this. So, the other one, the other piece of the T flip-flop will be with magenta reset circuit. In the end, we'd simply have to connect all those magenta lines to end up with a finished casino. So next up is the yellow circuit, and for this we have to dig down here a little bit and place in here 3 pieces of redstone dust. Here will be another yellow line, which is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, with 1 block in between. And we punch out those blocks too. Here is another line of redstone, here's another line of redstone, and then we have simply put a repeater in there and 3 repeaters in there. So here's now our redstone clock, and the redstone clock is, as said in the tutorial, is 2 ticks, 3 ticks, then 2 pieces of redstone, again 3 ticks, 2 ticks, and another piece of redstone. That's our clock, and from here on we can use the lime wool. Place it here and put in a redstone. That's where we connect our green circuit afterwards. Because the next circuit we want to put in is the white one, and we start over here with simply repeater set to 4 ticks, 2 pieces of redstone, redstone torch. Go down 2, go down 2, put redstone torches there. That's our end gates. And from here we simply put now the middle one. Then we want to grab ourselves a target block, redstone torch, another piece of redstone dust. And here we have to connect the last one with repeater set to 1 tick, repeater set to 4 ticks, 2 pieces of redstone. So now we want to grab ourselves the gray wool, which will be right here. That's our end gates with the torch, 1 above 2, and block 1 up again like this. And that's where also our second end gates will come in. Like this and like this, or the second part of the end gate. So that's our end gates. From here on we will connect the red circuits afterwards. So it's basically 8 blocks, 8 pieces of redstone, again 8 blocks, 8 pieces of redstone, 8 blocks, 8 pieces of redstone. And from here on we build up like this. Then we have here 2 comparators. Then we build up again with a piece of redstone and a comparator, up again, redstone, comparator. For the middle line, we simply have 2 pieces of comparators, redstone, comparator, redstone, comparator. So we should end up with the same amount of comparators in the same direction and the same way. Then we have the bottom ones, 2 comparators, piece of redstone, comparator, piece of redstone, and a comparator, like that. That's the last row. And we should have 1, 2, 3 blocks should fit in between both of those gaps. So for the green circuit, we block up like this. We're here at the bottom this time. We have here a piece of redstone. We have here a comparator set as subtraction mode, here a comparator. Then we're gonna have here a block set to subtraction mode, block on top. Then we wanna have here a piece of redstone again, here a block, piece of redstone, separate those 2 lines, and then we want to have another block over there. So that's the first part of this machine done. So now we're on the other side. Here we want to start diagonally here with the redstone torch. We want to put in here a comparator set as abstraction mode. Here a block. Another block. Two pieces of redstone. Here a comparator set to subtraction mode. On the bottom here we want to replace this one here with redstone. And then we already can put in our magenta circuit, which will be over here with redstone on top, here redstone torch. And we want to grab ourselves a lever. And we want to put it right here, so we can depower this if we want to. The last thing we want to add is a chest right here. At this point, simply put in one item and I will just put in this chest here. So next up, we want to place in here some lime wool right against this comparator here. Then a slab like this, so we prevent those two lines from connecting. And here, repeater set to 2 ticks. Then we want to make sure to grab ourselves a piston, put it in there, another block on top, and here basically a repeater. So if we put in now a redstone torch here, we should see that we have now signal strength 1. Push another redstone torch here, signal strength 2. So that's how we light all those lamps in the front. And if we pull ourselves this lever here, all the signal strength will disappear. And now we have to basically add in our hopper system. Here we're gonna start with building a block like that, like this and like this. Here a block again, 3 pieces of redstone, 3 blocks again, comparator, dropper, hopper, composter, another block here, redstone dust here, and then we want to put in here a stone sword and a non-stackable item, for example, this smooth quartz stairs here. So here this is actually a 50-50% odds to get to this repeater here. And then we simply have to build this whole contraption again 2 times over. So same stuff, we start with this green block here, one here and one there, and we simply put the same mechanisms 2 times on top. So I now copied the first layer basically 2 times over, so make sure that everything works. You can always test out the lamps and the rows and also the reset circuits. It's very important that everything works before you move on. So next up we want to connect all those lines, so this block will now connect up to here, and then we build our way up with a simple glass like that. So now everything is connected up here, and the next part we want to focus on is here the white circuits. So we already can run all the way this wool up to here. Then we have here 2 repeaters, both set to 1 tick, and then redstone fill the gaps. Actually, we want to make sure that those repeaters here are set to 4 ticks. It will help us afterwards with the AND gates. So then we want to observe when this repeater here on the back is lit up. And from here on, we simply want to go into a block. And from here on, in a repeater, another block, repeater, another block. That's our end block. Here we want to end up with. So we have here repeater, then piece of redstone. So this line is also connected up to this line. And last but not least, this repeater here placed like that. From here on, we can already start to add our AND gates into one single circuit. And we will start here with this torch in the middle, like this. We can also now put in here a repeater like that, so it prevents it from connecting to this circuit over there. And from here on, we simply can go down like that, and then go down once more like this. And here we can then punch out this whole line here, replace it with some redstone dust, and we want to end up here in this block, which is powering the dropper on top. We want to make sure we have a repeater here set to 2 ticks, and also a block here, and then we can fill it up with redstone like that. So last one is this torch here, and we want to make sure we have here this like that, and like this. Just to be sure, we simply add a repeater in there, throw it in, so you will make sure that your prices will get spit out. We simply start here with our redstone. We want to make sure we bring it right over here. Is there a redstone torch? Yes, so we cannot use this block. We have to go like this. Is there anything connecting already? Yes, it is. So we have to put in here some blocks. We could use here a redstone to put it nicely. So, and then, yeah, we have to go up like that and go like this. I guess that's more efficient if we do it like that. So that's it. So we have to connect this line to this line here. We have here a repeater in between to make sure that everything is fine. Nice. So I can work with that. So from here on, we want to make sure we build out a 2x3 platform over here. So it's like this. And we want to avoid connecting to this redstone line. And we also want to place in two comparators facing in opposite directions to have here a nice pulse extender. Then we want to make sure we have some magenta glass. And from here on, we want to stack simply up this line here, like this. And here we can already put in a repeater set to 4 ticks. It will power this circuit here. And it will power it twice since we have here observers. This will observe it. And if we trigger then this circuit, it will reset some lamps. They will go off and it will trigger one time again, putting a signal again, this pulse extender, therefore extending the pulse even more. And from here on, a repeater set to 1 tick. And we have to connect all those lines together. And yeah, it doesn't matter where you start. We simply, yeah, doesn't matter where you start. We simply go up like this. Does it work? No, we have to, of course, make some adjustments. Yeah, that should work out like that. That's the first one taken care of. Already the second one taken care of. And from here on, we will also block upwards like this. And we simply connect all lines. Then we want to make sure to get this line connected. So we staircase our way up here. And from here on, we simply want to make sure that we invert the signal. So we can already start, for example, from here. And we have to connect these two lines in the end like that. So we could also remove this block here. We have here a block. We're on the top. Just put the redstone torch, 2 ticks, 2 ticks, and then the sticky piston here in the middle, and do it like that. So it looks kind of like this. So the last thing we want to do is add some node blocks. And for this, you can choose any tone basically you want. We will start here. We have here 2 ticks, then we have a whole row. So we have node block, 2 ticks, node block, 2 ticks, node block, 2 ticks, node block. So now I want to go out here. And then we have, I will do simply like 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And now we should be able to play the casino. Everything is done. We can now test it. So let's give it a try. Let's go with gold. Oh, I guess we're good. Come on, let's do it. Yes, we won. And now it should reset itself. And here we have our 2 diamond blocks. Great. And also the casino reset completely, so we can put in now some new currency and everything is back to normal. If something didn't work out, since it's a very complicated build, make sure to check out my block by block tutorial. You can pause at any second. And if it doesn't help with the block by block tutorial, there's also a world download link in the video description. And yeah, with that said, I really, really appreciate your nice comments in suggesting more and more casinos and more crazy ideas. Thank you for watching. Make sure to like this video if you made it this far into the video, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye bye!